Let us take some simple problem to solve by matrix method. I have taken a continuous beam with two spans only, and A is fixed, B is a support where beam is continuous and support C is the end moment. Both of them are the simple one, but this is simple. Of course, beam is continuous, so it will be treated as your rigid joint only, and A is a support and C is a support. So first of all, you have to find out how many degrees of freedom, so that we can select the coordinates required to solve this problem. How many unknowns are there now? So degrees of freedom, if you look at this now, support A is fixed. You don't have any degrees of freedom. Here it is zero. It cannot move in horizontal direction. It cannot move in vertical direction and as well as rotation also. So whereas if you come to this support B now, it can move in horizontal direction and rotation also, whereas at C also it can move in horizontal and rotation. Since we assume that support A is fixed, there will be no horizontal translation of the member A, B, C. So we neglect that horizontal movement of the beam in the axial direction. Once you neglect it, you will get only 2 degrees of freedom, that is the rotation at B and the rotation at C. So for this problem now, degrees of freedom will be equal to 2. They are nothing but your theta B and theta C. I can put it here, neglecting axial deformation. Axial means along the axis of the member. We have to neglect it. It means that the length of AB and BC does not change. Assuming this condition, we can eliminate those 2 degrees of freedom, the horizontal movement at B and the horizontal movement at C. So we get only the 2 degrees of freedom, that is the rotation at B and rotation at C. That means your number of coordinates to be selected only 2 now. So they are nothing but these D1 and D2, the deformation at B and the deformation at C. So the number of coordinates are 2, degrees of freedom is 2. Your stiffness matrix size will be equal to 2 cross 2 because N is equal to 2. So for that, we have to assume that these 2 rotational directions as your coordinate directions. If you coordinate direction, if you write it now, let me take this beam ABC. Since there are 2 degrees of freedom here, I will put, always assume the clockwise only as your coordinate 1. See that I am writing for the coordinate 1 means always with the circle. So it means it is a coordinate direction 1. And at C, the next coordinate that represent the rotation at C, that is theta C, that is coordinate 2. So you have 2 degrees of freedom, 2 coordinates selected. So this figure shows the coordinate directions. Coordinate directions. So therefore now your displacement matrix, you can fix it now. Therefore, the displacement matrix D will be equal to D1 and D2. They are actually theta B and theta C. So once you get, you know the stiffness relation now. Stiffness relation is P is equal to K into D. So this is 2 cross 1, this is 2 cross 1. Automatically your stiffness matrix will be 2 cross 2. So for the force matrix now P, so if you have anything applied along the coordinate directions, applied moment here, couple, if they give a moment here, whether clockwise, anticlockwise, I have to take them into consideration in the case of force matrix. That will be equal to Pi minus Pil. I represent number of coordinate directions here, there are only two, P1 and P2. If it is P1 here, this should be an applied moment in the given problem. Minus of P1L means, is there any moment developed because of the applied load along this point B, along the coordinate 1, that should be added. Combination of these two, your force values, this force matrix combining of this PI is equal to P1 and P2. Actually, the force matrix here now, force matrix P will be equal to P1 and P2. That is to be found out as P1 minus P1L, P2 minus P2L. These two are, the second column of them is, all of them are due to applied load. And this is there any particular couple applied at B and C along the coordinate directions 1 and 2 that needs to be considered. Now to find out this P1L and P2L, I have to find out the frictional moments that you used to do it in your slope deflection moment distribution. Assuming AB as fixed beam, let us calculate MFAB, MFBA. Similarly, assuming BC as fixed beam, calculate MFBC and MFC. That step you know already. I'm just calculating now. This is the actually the first step of calculation. These are all basics of your stiffness approach. Frictional moments, MFAB is equal to minus MFBA. Why I am putting it is minus and plus here? Because it is symmetrically loaded now. AB is symmetrically placed with a point load now. The equation is minus WL by 8 minus 60 into L is 6 divided by 8. So that is equal to minus 45 kilonewton meter. That means MFAB is minus 45, MFBA is plus 45. So coming to second beam, MFBC is also equal to minus MFCB. Because load is symmetrically placed, UDL over the entire span, the equation is small w L square by 12 minus 10 into L is 6 square divided by 12. So it is equal to, I think 30, it is minus 30 kilonewton meter. So MFBC is minus 30, MFCB is plus 30.